welcome back to another video. Today we will be doing a studio tour. Okay, I wouldn't call this a studio, it's more like a very small sunroom that was added onto the house long before we bought it. As you can see, the floor-to-ceiling windows kind of imply that they use this room for sunning and such activities. But it's mine, and this is where I come to make all of my art and spend most of my time. It's my little oasis here. Okay, so we'll step inside real quick. Pardon my very squeaky floor. From right to left, I'll give you a good pan over. As you can see, I have quite a lot of plants. They are one of my most favorite hobbies, aside from art, of course. And we'll actually be starting over here on the left with this cabinet. This cabinet holds literally all of my art supplies. And it was one of the very first pieces of furniture I ever owned as an adult. Okay, so we'll start up here on the top. We have little knickknacks and figurines. Just stuff I've collected over the years. Including plants, of course. That's an aloe over there. A coyote skull and a Patron bottle. And then a Raven ZZ over here. Then we'll move on into the main cabinet. This holds all of my art supplies. And let me just open the door. Kind of got it jammed packed in here. So this is where all of my stuff is. Alright, so on the doors, I put on some Lee Ellison postcards that I thought were really cute and kind of livened up my piece of furniture. And a portrait of my boyfriend. Then over here on the top shelf, we have, to the left, all of my old sketchbooks and old art that I've drawn over the years. Literally almost every piece that I could grab, I've grabbed. I'm talking from middle school all the way up till now. And I used to have a really, really bad habit. I used to rip my sketchbooks apart and cut around the drawings to make them fit into binders like this, because I thought that was cool for some stupid reason. I regret that deeply. I wish I had more finished sketchbooks like these guys here, so it looks a little bit better, but all of my really old drawings from when I was young are in these three things here, and that one, which holds pieces from school, like the really big project kind. Then over here in the middle, we have my not-even-have-finished Copic sketchbook. And a little to-go sketchbook that I like to use every now and then. These are just some cutouts of cats and llamas that I glued in my sketchbook. And these are stickers by Mothsprout on Instagram. I love their art, and I love their stickers. I just haven't put them on anything yet. These are all of my yet-to-be-used sketchbooks that I've hoarded quite recently. Most of them are ordered online, some are bought in stores like Michael's and such like that, and this one's actually kind of more special. This is a really old one that I bought at a Renaissance festival years and years and years ago that has yet to be used. It's all hand-bound leather and I think handmade pages. Haven't used it yet, I've been too nervous. Sketchbook fear is real with that one. Okay. Then down here on the second shelf, starting on the right, we have most of my coloring supplies, I guess you could say. So we have Copic markers that I got as a present from my boyfriend. Pens, fine liners, and in the back, spare pencils. This is my pencil sharpener. I don't use these very often for art. I use them more for writing in my sketchbook than I do anything else, but they're really nice. These These are my Uniball Signo pins, which I like to use more than the Jelly Roll pins. I feel like they go on the paper a little bit better and don't get as clumped up. I have Microns here in the back, but I don't use them as often as I use these, which I have used for literal years and years. They are Prismacolor Premier Fineliners, and I got them in all kinds of sizes and such like that. I use them all the time. I love these things, and they're significantly cheaper than Microns. And over here we have a couple other things. This is my fixative that I spray onto my finished drawings so they don't get worn out onto a different page. Some watercolor jars in the back. And this is a colored pencil roll that I got from a friend years and years ago, who actually gave it to me, I think, as a birthday or graduation present that I still use. Holds almost all of them, and it's really handy for taking on the go. It actually buckles around your waist like a belt, too, so that's really cool. And over here, we have most of my watercolor supplies and some extra colored pencil. Right now, I'm using these My Artscape brushes. They're alright. I've used them for a long time, and they're still really good. I like them a lot. They don't hold a lot of water, but they do get the job done. Then over here, we have my liquid masking tape that I got for really cheap on Amazon. I don't use it so much. Then I have my three watercolor mediums. This is a Winsor & Newton White Nights palette. I wish I could say I used it a bunch, but I don't. This is what I use more. This is a Prang watercolor set. I don't know why. I just really like the way colored pencil goes off the top of it. It's super smooth and it has a great finished look to it. Then I have my Maya Hemi gouache, which I really enjoy using. Okay, so that's that. Give this guy a close. And down here are just a couple of drawers where I keep stupid junk, like rags and travel cases, journals I haven't used, paintbrushes, just junk. And this is junk too. It's just like pop figures and crystals and that kind of stuff. Okay, moving on, heading over here. And this is a shelf for my plants, mostly. My Brazil philodendron and golden pothos, ZZ plants and some orchids. Now these are called Dragonkin, and they are made by Bella Enchanted Studios over on Instagram. She makes insanely cool figurines like these all the time, and they're beautiful. I love them. So I've collected a few. I have a Mocha Dragonkin, a Cookies and Cream Dragonkin, and of course a Pumpkin Pie Dragonkin. I love them to death. I think they're so cute. Moving on down here is where I keep some of my journals, then an orchid and a regular philodendron. And these are some tarot decks that I have yet to use. I got them for my birthday. They're both really lovely. Excited to use this one. Shiny. And on the bottom, just a couple of books and yet more plants. And a nice little tubby Snorlax. I love Snorlax. He's one of my favorites. That chip bucket holds more jars, like empty mason jars and stuff. Then of course I have more plants. I won't list them all. Maybe someday I'll do a plant tour. But basically this is the extent of my hobby. This thing right here, I got this for a remembrance present when my cat passed away a couple of years ago. Her name was Lala, and I really miss her. And this pencil I actually used to draw almost every single thing for 6 or 7 years until the end broke and I could not put it back together. Sad, but you'll be remembered, old friend. All right, getting up now. All right, that's my Monstera. It's one of my pride and joys. Then along the floor in the front of my desk, I kind of have all of my orchids because I don't have a ton of space for them. They seem to be happy there. They're all throwing out new leaves anyway, so I'm just going to leave them where they're at and they'll be fine. And more plants on the floor. It's my dirt jar, and this is where I keep all my repotting supplies like soil and perlite and that kind of boring stuff. And up here we have a lemon lime philodendron, crispy wave fern, and my watering cans, cause these plants are a bunch of thirsty bitches and I love them so much. Alright. This is a really big shelf, so hang in there. This is where I keep all of my cuttings from all of my pothos plants. I have 3 of them. So 3 different kinds. Got my trimmers, my moisture meter, and these guys are all doing pretty well in this jar. Some are from my golden pothos, like these over here, and some are from my snow queen, or marble queen, which is right here. And more watering stuff, and so I keep my tweezers to pick things off my plants if I see any, like dead leaves and stuff. And this is where being a plant mom gets annoying, because these are all pots that I have to use at some point. Getting plants is a never-ending cycle, I promise you that. Alright. Then we have my window, and over there are some more art supplies in my closet. Not really much in here, just incense sticks, some acrylic paint, toolbox, some glue, and that kind of stuff. And then over here, we have a couple of things that I made. Sorry, you can see my camera. But I made portraits of all of my pets that have passed away. That's Sailor. He was an English bulldog. He was a very, very cuddly boy. And over here is Diamond. She was a Boston Terrier Pitbull mix, and I loved her to death. And then that's Lala, the cat I was talking about earlier. Loved her to death. And then we just have something I got for graduation over there. And this is my desk. This is where I look out at every day and just kind of chill out and make my art. There's a small drawer here. Holds stuff like little notepads, extra pens, clips, and X-Acto knives, tape, little scissors, ruler, and an extra pencil sharpener, which is this thing right here, the nose. And that's about it.